Vicky Beeching aus London. Eine Lobpreisleiterin geht zu den Menschen. Mit ihrem Album Eternity Invades möchte sie Menschen mit Gott in Kontakt bringen. Das und mehr jetzt bei Destiny, deinem Jugendmagazin aus Berlin.
Herzlich willkommen bei Destiny, deinem Jugendmagazin aus Berlin. Wir haben heute wieder ganz viele Musikvideos für euch, unter anderem mit Gospel, Worship und vieles mehr. Und zuerst spielen wir Ty Tribbett, richtig?
Genau, ein ziemlich verrückter Kerl, werdet ihr gleich sehen. In seinem Song Stand Out, heißt der, da singt er davon, dass wir in einer Zeit leben, in der wir keine Kompromisse machen sollen, in der wir uns entscheiden sollen, wofür wir wirklich leben wollen, wofür es wert ist zu leben. Und er hat es anscheinend schon für sich selbst rausgefunden. Hier kommt er mit Stand Out.
Vicky Beeching ist eine englische Musikerin, die Musik in der Kirche macht, für Gott und für die Menschen dort. Und sie hat jetzt in London ihr neues Album aufgenommen.
Genau, das heißt Eternity Invades. Und worum es da geht und wie sie so an ihrem Album gearbeitet hat und was Vicky sonst so treibt, das schauen wir uns jetzt mal an.
Weather today, we didn't put on any sunshine for you. Put in him, would live forever. Got my polka dot brolly. Big Ben over there and the Houses of Parliament. Genuine London life here, loud, wet and fantastic. I've written really have come out of this place, you know, even though I spend a lot of time now in very kind of Christian places, a lot of churches, a lot of conferences, this is really where I came from and where my home is, and this is where I want to root what I do. You say the word and mountains are moving. Growing up I was really into music and my mum's a worship leader, so I would watch her every Sunday leading worship on the piano or the guitar. One Sunday when I was 12, my mum was actually ill and there was no one else in the whole congregation that could lead, so that was my first baptism by fire into worship leading. Like, and I think that was really the moment when I felt like, yes, I found the thing, you know, I found the thing that I want to do with my life, to try and give people the words to say to him that they can't find themselves. People ask me a lot of questions about being a woman worship leader, because there aren't a ton of those in kind of full-time traveling recording ministry. It was interesting, when I was growing up, I never really thought that women couldn't be in a position of leadership. As a kid, the Prime Minister at the time was Margaret Thatcher, and she obviously is a woman, and the Queen is a she. So growing up in England, it was cool to like have two women really running the country, and I think that just gave me a sense that women really can be used to make a difference. So my heart is just to be a role model and to show the next generation that the girls really, really can step up and God really can use you. Definitely one of my major passions as a worship leader and a songwriter is engaging with issues of social justice. So we're coming, we're filming now from an area in downtown London called Soho, which is a very, very artistic kind of, there's a lot of fashion, a lot of film going on, but it's also very, very sadly the epicenter of prostitution, and it's known as the red light district of London and has been so for about 200 or 300 years. And you kind of see the kind of environment that I'm in here, and I think as a worship leader it's very important to me that I'm not just locked up in a church somewhere, or in terms of theology, that I'm not just hidden away in an ivory tower. I want to be somewhere very real that really feels like I'm aware of what's going on in the world. So one of the songs on my album is called Break Our Hearts, and it's a real prayer that God would break our hearts with the things that break His. Break our is such a clear picture of something that breaks God's heart, human trafficking and the sex industry. It's just so full of depravity and darkness, and people are really trapped in that. Even now as I stand here, I know there's men and women trapped in this industry right now, and that that really led me to write the song Break Our Hearts.
Break our hearts with the things that break yours. Wake us up to see through your eyes.
So my prayer is that I would be a worship leader who leads in word and in deed, and that we would be worshippers in justice and mercy as well as song. Amos 5 tells us that if we're offering worship that isn't full of justice and mercy, then that offering of worship is actually just basically a noise to God's ears. But the kind of worship he's looking for is to actually break the chains of the people who are enslaved, and it is to give our food to the hungry and welcome the homeless into our homes. So I'm trying to really make that a part of my life and a part of my songs. Yeah, I'm a total online junkie. My laptop's basically always in my hand and open, and my passion really is to engage with people on the internet in the kind of cybersphere, because that I feel like a lot of my mission is actually about finding young people and speaking their language where they're at. So I love Twitter. You can follow me on Twitter, it's twitter.com/VickyBeeching, and I'm always on there sending updates, photos from parts of my day, showing where I am, showing what I'm doing. I'm a big blogger, and you can check out my blog, it's VickyBeeching.com. And I just love impacting that world, sharing who I am, getting to know the people on there, and I consider it a very important part of ministry now, and I think it will be a huge part of ministry in the future.
Glory to God.
So when I was deciding what to call the album, I went for Eternity Invades, because I believe that worship, sung worship, actually is a place where heaven and earth meet. So the things of eternity, which really are, you know, like the book of Revelation says, no more pain, no more crying, no more suffering. If eternity's breaking in, then we can expect that God is going to bring some of those things, you know, to us as we worship. So it's not a place of boring safety, it's actually an exciting place. So I hope that album title raises people's expectations of what can happen in worship.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God.